Engineering Preview. I hope you're excited to be here. I hope you are well, and I hope you're ready to learn a lot of information about FAMU-FSU College of Engineering. So up on our screen here is just a quick PowerPoint that we're going to go through, but I definitely want to introduce our Dean, Dean Murray Gibson, and he's going to give you all an awesome welcome.
Thank you, Kayla. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm sorry that we have to do it virtually, but it's still a great way that we can communicate. We want to tell you about the college, and we're excited about the possibility of you joining us. We hope that you will join us in the fall. And let me just quickly say, we're going to focus a lot more on the majors this time. Last time I gave a bit of a longer introduction, but I'll be around in the main room for anyone who has more questions. Let me just quickly summarize the college. We're unique in being a partnered school. We have a lot of really cool things that come about because of that. One of them is seen from the Florida State point of view, which is one of the top 20 universities in the nation. We are among the smaller and more intimate engineering schools of that kind, in fact, by far. So at the same time, we have the same quality in terms of research of places like UF and Georgia Tech and so on, but you get an environment that's a lot more intimate. On top of which, Florida is the least expensive state in the nation to go to college, so that's another attraction. From the FAMU point of view, we are the most highly ranked in School of Engineering amongst the HBCUs. And what we have by the partnership is we have the diversity that no one else has, and I'll say more about that. We also have research facilities that are really unique because of our association with the top research university, Florida State. And those are all around the college. They're physically, the college is a couple of miles from the two campuses. We have good transportation available. Around us, we have 6 or 7 buildings that are dedicated to engineering research. And you'll hear more about that when you talk to people in the major and I can answer some questions. Just finally, I want to emphasize diversity. We are the most diverse top-ranked school of engineering in the country. And that is, I think, a very important thing. We, by the way, have, in terms of racial and ethnic identity, we're pretty close to the diversity of the United States, and no other engineering school is. And I think that brings something to our students, whether you're majority or minority, that's valued by industry, because they really want everyone to understand how to work in cross-cultural teams. And you get a great education here, and you learn those skills. You have the joy of being a Knoll or a Rattler. If you're a Rattler, you can enjoy the unique aspects of an HBCU and yet still get that experience in the real world that you wouldn't be able to find at any other HBCU. As a student at FSU, you'll be exposed also to the real world in a way that you wouldn't otherwise. And that attracts a lot of companies to come to our campus to recruit our students, because they want students who have the engineering skills and the soft skills that come from that sort of thing. So that's something you won't find anywhere else in the nation. So I'll stop now, and I'm ready to answer questions a little later. So I'll pass you back to Kayla to go on with the agenda.
All right, awesome. Thank you, Dean Gibson. So for our schedule today, you had the welcome. I'm going to give you a brief overview of the schedule layout. Based on the majors that you indicated in your registration form, you have already been placed, or you will be assigned into specific breakout rooms based on those major interests. And then if you choose to come out of that room, you'll just write that in the chat box. But I have another slide later that'll give you a bit more details on that. So next, I want to introduce two of our pre-engineering advisors. They're going to do a quick overview for you. And then lastly, we'll do the major specific breakout sessions, which is really the bulk of what this is about. We want you to be able to focus more on learning about your major specifically. So without further ado, I want to introduce Ms. Sheila Martin. She's a FAMU pre-engineering advisor, and Mr. Willie Leparulo, who is our FSU pre-engineering advisor.
Hello, I didn't know it was my time to speak. I am Sheila Martin, pre-engineering advisor for FAMU. Welcome.
Hey all, I'm Willie Leparulo. I'm the FSU pre-engineering advisor. Welcome. Sheila, you wanna go ahead and start?
Okay, first off on our agenda, we're gonna talk about the pre-engineering requirements. The Calculus 1, Calculus 2, first year engineering course, and also Physics 1 for all majors except for the chemistry and biomedical. you will need to have your calculus one, your chemistry one, general chemistry one. Willie?
Yeah, I mean, basically it's the same kind of stuff there. And, you know, depending on what you all end up majoring in, everyone will be coded as something pre-engineering, whether it's pre-engineering mechanical, pre-engineering chemical, you name it. And so, you know, on your end there, it's exciting to be a part of a cohort along those lines. And so that's the sort of the pre-engineering, I like to call it a waiting area until you get into the big leagues, which is the actual engineering major there. So between Sheila and I, we will be helping you all make it through the whole pre-engineering process on how that works. So there are each different university portals for each, for FAMU and for FSU. And so for the FSU side is the Student Center. And then Sheila, for the FAMU side, it's?
The iRattler.
Right, and so each student should be familiar with your respective university portals. This is where you can look and see your classes, what kind of tuition you owe, if you have any academic holds, all of that good stuff. It's a one-stop shop kind of area that is good for everybody to know. And we in pre-engineering will definitely help you move forward with that in terms of how that works.
Yes, and while we're in the remote environment, we would ask that everyone would go ahead and get your FAMU email address and also your FSU email address so that you can check the system. Because if you're emailing us from your personal email address, we, FAMU, we can't answer back. So some of you may have emailed me, but I'm not able to respond to your personal. So it'll be a good idea to go ahead to activate your university email address, whether you're admitted or not.
Yeah, same thing for Florida State. We'd prefer, highly strongly suggest that you use your FSU email. We're not completely at liberty to reply back to a personal email. We want to make this, you all to get into the habit, because professors will be contacting you on your school email, not on the Gmail or so forth kind of account. I think the last thing that we want to make sure everyone is aware of is the different math and science transferable credit, the dual enrollment, AP, IB, even ACE credit. So that's important for us as advisors, because we want to help you guys map out your paths in your different majors. And so collecting that kind of information when you get it, of course, because AP and IB sometimes are a little delayed in grading those. I think they come out, in July or something like that. But keep in mind, we need that kind of information, and you should also have it as well. Sheila, what else do you have to add?
Okay, as far as your transferable hours, make sure that your science and math levels, a lot of students that transfer in may have only taken the geometry, stats, and your algebra. But make sure you're moving up to your pre-calculus and calculus areas so that you have a better outlook on what the majors need you to have those calculus-based classes as well.
And I think that is it for us in the pre-engineering area. I think that's it for me at least.
We have one more, the curriculum maps. In order to get to the curriculum map, if you want to Google FAMU-FSU College of Engineering, once you get there, you'll see the student tab. Once you get to the student tab, you'll see resources. You click on the resources in the column for student guide. Your curriculum maps will be found there. So it'll be a good idea to pull those curriculum maps for your desired major so that you can see which courses you'll be taking and courses you should be in so that you will be prepared for your college level courses. And I believe that's it for us.
Yep.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Thank you, Ms. Martin. Thank you, Mr. Leparulo. And we'll be sure to include the link for those curriculum maps in the chat. So just keep an eye out on the chat. All right. This is a really important slide. So if you want to know more about student life, If you have more questions after the preview, we're going to send a link out to you via email after the preview's over. And you'll be able to schedule one-on-one Zoom sessions with current undergraduate students to talk more about student life. So we specifically have this slide because this session, we want you to focus on your majors. The previous preview that we did a couple weeks ago, we got to get a lot of in-depth information about student life. But for this particular one, when you go into your breakout sessions, we really want you all to focus on your major and curriculum and just learning more about jobs and careers and things of that nature, research interests, etc. So just make sure that you're focusing on those types of questions. And then if you have questions about student life, then I would love for you to sign up for a one-on-one Zoom session where you can actually have some time with a current undergraduate student to learn more about what it's like to be an engineering student. You can also email me if you have further questions, but the link will be sent out to you as soon as the preview is over. All right, so here's the good stuff. So we're gonna deep dive into your majors, the breakout sessions, as I mentioned before, you'll be placed into those based on your area of interest or the major interest that you indicated when you registered for this particular workshop, but you're welcome to explore other departments. So let's say if you're interested in mechanical engineering, but you also have an interest in chemical, what you're gonna do is if you wanna switch rooms, you're just gonna exit the breakout session that you're in and then come back to the, that'll send you back to the main room, and then you'll write in the chat where you want to go. And then our wonderful marketing team, Miss Jenny, will place you into the other breakout session that you're interested in. In addition to the breakout sessions, everyone that you heard from today, with the exception of our wonderful FSU mapping coordinator, I definitely want to highlight her. I saw that we had an FSU transfer student that did register. All of these people will still be inside of the main room. So if you all have questions for us specifically, if you want to ask the advisors a couple more questions, myself as the recruiter, Dean Gibson's here, he's a wealth of knowledge, as well as Ms. Hillary Campbell, who's our FSU mapping coordinator, you can come back to main room and ask us questions here as well, in addition to the breakout sessions. So at this point, I'm gonna have you guys go ahead and head out to your breakout sessions. As I mentioned, we'll be here. Thank you so much for being here. Definitely ask some good questions in those breakout sessions because you've got some really good folks in there that are excited to talk to you. Thank you. Okay, so it's gonna take a few more minutes to get you all into your breakout sessions. Our marketing team is working really hard to get that done. So in the meantime, we have, you know, all of us are inside of the main room now. So if you all have follow-up questions for the advisors or questions for anyone that's here in the main room, outside of, you know, the major folks, because you'll get to speak with them when you're in your breakout sessions, feel free to write those questions in the chat and we can kind of go through and answer those now. So, if everyone could just take a look at the chat and we'll see what questions you all have.
While we're waiting for the questions, I just was going to add something. I see someone's typing one. The so you heard from the pre-engineering advisors about when you are beginning as a pre-engineer, you'll study at Florida State or Florida A&M to do your core courses. But as soon as you're taking courses at the college, and that includes the course we offer to pre-engineers called First Year Engineering Lab, those are all done jointly. We have our own separate learning management system. So effectively our students are blended together and the faculty don't know who's FAMU and who's FSU. So that's what's unique about this college. Our engineering education is entirely shared. The only part which is done by the two universities is the pre-engineering math and science.
Thank you, Dean Gibson. So we got a question, do we take the majority of courses at our college and then then attend the College of Engineering part-time? Do one of the advisors want to answer that question, or I can also?
I can jump in, and Sheila, of course, can say stuff too. In the very beginning, your college career, a lot of that you're gonna be at your respective campuses. Like Dean Gibson said, the one class that you'll take in the very beginning is the First Year Engineering Lab, and that's on the FAMU-FSU College of Engineering campus. And so a lot of freshmen come in and you'll see, you know, anywhere from 13 to 16 hours, that's like maybe 5 to 6 classes. One class in the very beginning will be at the College of Engineering, and then the remainder will be at your home campuses. But as you progress forward, you'll start to see a switch. You'll start to see a couple classes at the College of Engineering and a couple classes on your main campus until it comes to the point where you are taking every class at the college.
That's correct. I would like to add that even though you may not be taking courses, only your pre-engineering course before you get into the major courses, I always encourage students to visit the school, the College of Engineering. It is a different atmosphere out there where you see a lot of students studying. You have your own cafeteria. You have the different libraries and different areas for your major. And it is very important to utilize the space that's out there and not just wait until you're in the actual major. A lot of students get familiar with each other and create different studying sessions and everything out in the building. It's a very good idea to come out there to the building to study and do your work, regardless if you're in the major or you're just in the pre-engineering course.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. Thank you. Thank you for answering. Okay, so we have another question. Are there advisors specifically for transfer students? That's a really good question. I can answer that question. So for on the FSU side, either Mr. Leparulo or Ms. Campbell can work with you pretty much for transfer students, but Ms. Campbell does work, I think, mostly with the transfer students. So she will be your go-to contact if you are an FSU transfer student. I would suggest, you know, hanging out in the main room or either coming back so that you can have some one-on-one time with Ms. Hillary Campbell if you're an FSU student. On the FAMU side, we have Ms. Sheila Martin, and she does work with undergraduate students as well as transfer students. Great question. And in addition to what Ms. Martin mentioned about making sure that you spend some time at the pre-engineering or at the engineering campus, I know, you know, we're focusing on majors, but we're going to get to that once you all get into your breakout rooms. But in terms of the student life aspect, there are a lot of organizations that you can join that are at the College of Engineering. We have roughly 25 student orgs that you can join. So those are interest-based or identity-based. So identity-based would be like NSBE, the National Society for Black Engineers. We have SWE, the Society for Women Engineers, SHEP for Hispanic Engineers, and then the interest space would be based on your major interests, of course, or what your career interests are. So we have SAE, Society for Automotive Engineers, which is a car building club. They build Formula One and Baja race cars. We have ASCE for civil engineering. We have a lot of different organizations that you can join once you get to the College of Engineering that can also, you know, keep you plugged into the engineering campus. Great questions. Keep them coming.
Also, I wanted to add that even though we're pre-engineering advisors, we do have offices located at the engineering school, as well as for myself at the FAMU campus, and Willie over at the FSU campus. So on certain days, you will always be able to reach out to us or visit our offices as well.
Great point. Great point. Thank you. All right. We've got two more questions. Could you double major in two engineering areas, or would it be recommended? I'm going to let the advisors answer that question.
So on the FSU side, you know, again, there's something called excess credit, and we want to make sure everyone is aware of that. And so you can double major. It's been done before. What I would suggest is always working with Ms. Campbell, our, if you're on the FSU side, the mapping coordinator, just to make sure that everything is going to work out. There are certain majors that don't generally go together, but, you know, we have seen others that do. And so that's a conversation, I would say, with our mapping coordinator. I think that's probably your best bet.
If you don't mind me speaking to that for a moment. Hi guys, I'm Kim Brisbane. I'm the Chemical and Biomedical Engineering Upper Division Advisor. Like Willie mentioned, majoring in two engineering disciplines typically can be a lot more courses. So for these students, sometimes it's almost a better idea to do a bachelor's degree in one engineering discipline and then a master's degree in another one. Your earning potential is a lot different with a master's degree than with a bachelor's. So then you're getting a background in both disciplines that you're interested in, and your long-term career potential is a little different there too. That might be something to consider as well.
Also, I would like to add something aside from that. You also have to realize when you have financial aid, you can run out of aid as well. So that will be also a conversation with the majors, along with your financial aid offices, as well, if you're going to do take two majors at one time.
All right. Thank you. Yeah. Thanks for adding that, Kimber. That was a really good point. Thanks, Ms. Martin. So I think we're ready to put everyone in their rooms now. As I mentioned before, we're going to hang out in the main room. So the rest of these questions we can continue to answer. So if you ask the question and didn't get answered, we will definitely answer it. But I'm going to go ahead and let you guys go into your breakout rooms.
Hey everyone, real quick. I'm about to open these breakout rooms. If you are not assigned to one, that means that I either didn't have your name on the list or I can't identify who you are based on your name. So please send me a chat and let me know if there's a room that you want to go into and we'll get started.
I see there was a question in regards to a FAMU student. Can you reach out to an FSU advisor if the FAMU advisor is unavailable?
It's a good question. Do you wanna?
Yeah, but our go-to middle person is Masiagri for right. The student. So
right.
I wish I could have. If that student was still there to answer that question as well.
There are still 24 in the room, so that student potentially could be here. I think.
On the chat, if you want, you can respond to the question as a chat.
Yeah, you could definitely just answer it there.
Okay, all right, thank you.
Also, I know somebody asked about the virtual tour. I know we have a virtual tour, but somebody could put the link.
Yeah, I'm gonna include
that. Thank you.
Excuse me, I'm supposed to represent for FAMU undergrad for civil engineering. How do I get to the breakout room for that?
Just write it in the chat and our marketing team will put you in there. Thanks for letting us know.
No problem.
So there are still 22 students in the chat. So if the advisors, if you do want to answer the questions out loud, you can definitely do that. I'm going to put up the virtual tour link.
I'm not a pre-engineering advisor, but I'll go ahead and answer that question. And Sheila, Willie, feel free to jump in as well, but if you're not able to get a hold of advisor, you can definitely reach out to student services. It's the Office of the Associate Dean of Student Services and Undergraduate Affairs. That is the main student contact for the students in the College of Engineering. But if you're attending one university, we can certainly be helpful and answer any general questions. But if you have a question that's specific to FAMU or FSU process, I do recommend you speak directly with the advisor at that university. You can also contact Frederica Manciagli. She is the Director of Student Services, and she has knowledge of both FSU and FAMU policies. So she would be helpful as well.
If I could add to that, basically, once you become a major in the engineering school and are taking engineering courses, we, as I mentioned before, we have a uniform system. All our advisors within the departments advise both FAMU and FSU students. So from a point of view of engineering and meeting the requirements, there is no difference. And you go to the engineering advisor. The FAMU advisors are very important, certainly in the pre-engineering period, and perhaps regarding specific FAMU and FSU requirements for example, general education and those things, those you would go to the individual university. Although we can give you a lot of information, as was said from the student services office, they're very aware of those issues.
It seems that there's another question from Kim Kamata. Says, does the College of Engineering offer double degree programs where engineering students can stay in school one more full year and earn their master's degree like 5 years? So if that person is still listening, So there are majors you can do that. And generally when I, as a pre-engineering advisor, face a student that wants that information, I generally tell them it's 4+1 or 3+2, whatever it's called in terms of that, but to contact the major advisor once you get there, because those programs are out there. And certainly getting your bachelor's and master's all together within a certain time period does make you a bit more marketable along those lines. So yeah, it is possible.
Hi, Sheila. This is Tisha. We have Ms. Floyd, who has a couple of questions. It says, I'm in a dual degree biology and biomedical engineering student, and I'm a 3+2 program.
What's the question?
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, my name is Natralcia. Mm-hmm. I go to Xavier University of Louisiana, and I'm in the 3+2 program. So I spent 3 years at Xavier, and I'll spend 2 years at engineering school, and I'll earn a bachelor's in both biology and biomedical engineering when I'm done with the engineering program and Xavier's program. I'm transferring this year to engineering school, and I'm interested in FAMU, but I want to know how to plan my schedule because some of the prerequisites that are required for pre-engineering, I've completed like a year or two ago, but as far as like some of the specifics like mass and energy balances and process analysis and design, I haven't done those. And I know it's like some of the prerequisites are the co-requisites with those classes.
Okay, nice meeting you. With the pre-engineering part, if you've completed your calculus one, calculus two, and your chemistry one, have you completed those classes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I would not be your advisor. That would be Ms. Spann.
Okay.
Yeah, because you finished the pre-engineering courses, so therefore you'll be in the actual major.
Okay.
Yeah, does that make any sense?
Right, it does.
Okay, so if you have the pre-courses that is required to take your major courses, what'll happen is Ms. Spann will look over your transcript and also your academic module once it's active with all your courses in there. And if you finish your pre-courses, you'll just continue into the courses that are needed in order to complete the degree.
Okay.
Does that answer your question?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Well, I look forward to seeing you. Well, virtually for right now.
Yes, ma'am.
Ms. Floyd, I'm going to send you Kimber Spann's email so that you will have it and you can connect with her. She's in that CBE breakout right now that you just left.
Yes, ma'am. I also wanted to know if you had like any familiarity with dual degree students from different universities. Like,
yes.
Okay.
I was going to mention we are just developing an MOU with Xavier, specifically as I talked to the dean a year ago, and so we're excited that you're coming. We're going to try and get more students that path. Well, we do have other students who've done that from other universities. So Kimber can give you an answer, and if not there, come back to me or anyone else if you want to ask any other questions.
Okay, that's great.
Glad to have you.
Thank you so much. I've known
maybe it's a great school, but they don't have engineering, so it's kind of a win-win.
Right.
Right. Excellent. Glad to have you.
I've known one person to attend Xavier and FAMU. I think he's graduating this fall, if I'm not mistaken. I can't remember his name.
Okay, good, good. Well, stay in touch. Yeah, if you have any other questions, just let us know.
Okay, well, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Hi, I'm Kyla Hayes, and I'm from Austin, Texas. And I have a question about my dual enrollment through UT Austin. We have this program called on-ramps, and I'm taking on-ramps physics, and I was wondering if the credit would transfer over into the engineering college.
Kyla, could you say that again? It wasn't very clear. Are you in high school or are you in college? I missed the beginning, I'm sorry.
I'm in high school, but okay. We have this on-ramps program, and it's dual enrollment through UT Austin.
Okay.
And I was just wondering if the credit would transfer over.
Did you say it was physics?
Yes.
Is it a calculus-based physics?
I'm pretty sure it is.
Or is it algebra-based?
is it cal? I'm pretty sure it's calculus-based physics.
Okay. Well, I'm pretty sure that it should transfer as long as it's a college credit. Ms. Martin, if you have something you want to follow up with.
Yes, that's correct. If it is the physics, the college level physics with analytics, yes.
Okay.
Calculus based, yes.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome. Have any other questions?
So do you guys recommend taking calculus before you come to college?
Okay, at the college level, definitely.
Okay. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Yeah, math is really the most one of the most important things, and the more you do, the better. You can always retake a course or something that'll just strengthen your knowledge if you need to, but it's definitely advisable to take as much as you can.
Okay, and then I have one more question. Do you recommend, like, even if the physics credit does transfer, do you recommend retaking the physics class?
I wouldn't recommend retaking it unless it, again, if it's at the college level, then you should be fine to take physics 2 when you come.
Okay.
But it's also very important to make sure that you take your math and sciences, whether it be your calculus 1, calculus 2, chemistry 1, or physics 1. A lot of students transfer in taking a lot of general education courses. So you're taking a lot of your cushion courses out of the equation, and you're taking more strain courses at the same time. So, but it's very important in this major, again, as Dean Gibson said, the math and science is very important. So that'd be good if you take the calculus 1 and physics 1.
Okay, and then are there any like other specific requirements to be admitted to the College of Engineering or the pre-college?
Kyla, would you apply through FAMU or FSU, do you know?
I would apply through FAMU.
Okay, well maybe okay. Sheila could say a little bit more about that perhaps.
Okay, so for your admissions criteria, is that what you're asking?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so have you been notified whether you have been accepted or not?
Well, I'm a junior in high school right now. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, you can also still apply. Sometimes they give early yays or nays, or if you need further information. So basically, if you apply to the university, you'll get that information as to the requirements of your test scores and also your core courses you need to take through the admissions portal.
Okay.
Are you still there, Kayla?
Yes.
Kayla. Kayla McLaughlin is our recruitment coordinator. She deals a lot with students in high school and juniors, and I think maybe you want to talk with her as well.
Yes.
I'll give you some good advice.
Yeah.
You are, okay. Kyla is a junior in high school in Texas who wants to apply to FAMU, was asking some questions about, acceptance and other things. Maybe that's something you want to do offline. I don't know.
Sure. If you have specific questions that you want to ask,
she put her email right
there. I'm definitely here at your disposal, but I also did put my email there, if you want to email me, whatever works best for you, but I'm here. Any more questions?
Okay. I'll email you.
Okay, sounds good.
We just closed out our civil engineering session.
Good. There's a couple more students, I think, online, maybe one. If anyone has a question, feel free to ask. We talked to Kyla Hayes, but we haven't talked to Kema Carr. So it's up to you.
Hi, I actually just applied to FAMU.
Yeah.
I'm waiting on my acceptance. Like I applied I think a month ago. So the acceptance letter wouldn't come until June. But I don't know if this is a question I should ask you guys, if it's another question, but this is kind of has to deal with financial aid. I emailed the office and said I have to wait until I'm accepted before I can fill out financial aid application and things like that. But with that, would there still be Pell Grants and like funds, like all the way in June for me to use to pay for.
Did you complete your FAFSA and when did you complete that?
I actually did my FAFSA like in October. Okay. I sent it already to like FAMU.
Gotcha. Okay. I am pretty sure there will still be some financial aid left for you in June. And I put my email address in the chat. I'm not sure if, I think I actually sent it directly to Kyla. I'm going to put my email address back in the chat. But if you want to check on your application, I don't make admissions decisions, but I can view what admissions sees at FAMU. So I can, you know, check and just make sure that there's nothing missing on your part, because we want to make sure that we have all the components of your application so that they can evaluate it. But I'm pretty sure, to answer your question, I'm pretty sure there'll still be financial aid left for you upon that time when they admit you. So I wouldn't worry too much about it.
Yeah, and also in the meantime, if you can go ahead and get them to activate your iRattler. Once you go into the iRattler portal, you'll see your hold list and also your to-do list. Regardless if you did, when you did your FAFSA, there's also a verification sheet that you'll have to do, which is also listed in there for admittance. If you've been admitted, you can also see that on that screen as well. So, and if you're missing anything, you can see that on that screen as well. And also activate your FAMU email address so you can correspond back and forth with us as well.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, I'm going to say goodbye to the meeting. If anybody has any questions, I notice a couple of students still here. I'm Lisa Spainauer. I am the Chair of Civil and Environmental Engineering. So if anybody has any thoughts about civil engineering, you're welcome to ask. If not, I'm going to step out.
Thanks, Lisa.
Sure. Thanks, Murray. It's always fun to get to talk to prospective students, and having a couple of our students join in as well made it extra fun. So great way to spend a kind of rainy Saturday afternoon. Take care.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Are there other chat room or breakout rooms that are still going on? Is that what we're waiting on?
Mechanical and electrical are still going.
Okay.
Jenny and I can stay.
Okay.
Oh, well, thank you. I see some students have come in from the...
We just ended the breakout session. I was not sure how long. I know it was 3:00, but some students have still questions. We continued until a minute.
That's fine. Does anyone in the room have questions for the advisors? Or did you answer everything?
They have questions for advisors. I gave the advisor's name of ECE department.
Okay, all right.
The questions are mainly what can be transferred, what cannot be transferred. Right. And if they don't want to transfer something, they are qualified to transfer what is an offer.
Okay. Well, there are a number of students that they come into this room automatically if they don't sign out. So if anyone has a question for us, feel free to ask it. We're going to end the meeting pretty soon, but you're welcome to ask another question outside if you'd like.
Yes, we have Sheila Martin, our pre-engineering advisor here, and she will know a lot of those questions about transfers.
Mary, I just wanted to add our current students, 4 or 5 of our students joined. They did a very good job of answering students' questions and also talking about the environment at the college. Yeah. Classroom and labs and also research opportunities we have.
So you're still sharing with everyone, Sasfri. That's great. Yeah, I'm glad it went well. Now there are other people coming from mechanical. So if any of you, when people move out of the room, they end up back in the main room here. If anyone has any more questions for the pre-engineering advisor or myself, otherwise we're going to end the meeting soon. It's up to you. Just speak up if you do.
Ty's mother also joined. She asked a question we answered, but she had questions about what can be transferred. What is the advice we give to students who are planning to come with lots of credits already?
Hello, I'm Sheila Martin, pre-engineering advisor. I would say to pull the curriculum map for your desired major, view that map for the courses that you desire to take dual enrollment or while in high school, so that you won't transfer a lot of hours that will not go into the major. So you have your math, your science, your social science, your two social science, one core, non-core, your humanities core, non-core, in one of your social science core classes will be a civil literacy course. Again, pull the curriculum map so that you'll be familiar with the courses that are required moving forward into the major. Because a lot of times students transfer in a lot of hours that are 3 and 4 of your humanities or 3 and 4 social sciences, or and don't take the English or don't take the level of math that is required or the level of science that's required. So it's a lot of courses that will not be accepted. Go ahead.
Oh, thanks for sharing that information. Really appreciate it. Do you guys typically have summer programs for high school students over the summer, like summer camps or anything of that nature?
That's a really good question. So my name's Kayla McLaughlin. I'm the recruitment coordinator. We do typically have a summer camp, a NSBE summer camp. National Society for Black Engineers is not, you know, by any means limited to that population, but that's the organization that it's affiliated with, NSBE Junior. And we do usually hold a summer camp physically at the College of Engineering during the summer, but it is a non-resident program at the moment. We don't have any residential programs that are offered for high school students, so they would have to have somewhere to stay in Tallahassee if they were coming to that camp. Obviously, because of everything that's going on in the nation right now with the virus, we're not physically holding camp at the College of Engineering. But if you want to email, I've already put my email in the chat, but I'm not sure if you'll be able to see it. So I'm going to put it in here again. We are doing something cool virtually that's affiliated with summer camp. So if you just send me an email, I can forward that to my students that work with the NSBE Junior Camp, and we can get that information to you.
Okay, great. Thanks so much.
Yeah, no problem.
So this is Eric Hellstrom from Mechanical Engineering, and this is for, I guess, Ty's mom, who asked the question about what courses were advised to take. And over in Mechanical Engineering, we had this question from potential students and got students that are in mechanical engineering, as well as my own advice on this. And that is, if you have, for instance, AP credit for Calculus 2, don't take Calculus 3. Retake Calculus 2. If you've got Physics 1 AP credit, best to retake that Physics 1, because it's taught very differently in high school than it is in college. And you don't want to have problems in that Physics 2 class for your first semester at the university. So better to repeat them. It's not going to hurt you. You'll do much better. And you'll see that the first part of it is not a real problem because you know the information that's there, but then the teaching of it will change from what you had in high school, or even from one of the community colleges to the four-year campus. Okay.
Hi, I just wanted to comment. This is my name. I know my name shows up at USF, but I'm Keisha King. I'm a parent of my son's at a high school in an engineering program. It's a magnet program in Jacksonville, Florida, but that's valuable information. I was asking about dual enrollment courses, which ones would be preferable to take in high school versus on campus. So that was a great feedback. My son's also in NSBE. We have a chapter here in Jacksonville. So I would be interested in hearing more about, you know, how NSBE Junior is involved with any other opportunity that may circulate on campus. So I'll look forward to that content. You know, knowing that the COVID-19 does keep them away from joining together live, but definitely any virtual opportunities would be helpful.
Yeah, thank you for joining us. Definitely send me an email And I'll get you connected with the NSBE Junior chapter.
So just to kind of reiterate what Eric said, and maybe Kayla could add something to this, but I think he particularly focused on AP courses as opposed to dual enrollment college courses. But even with dual enrollment college courses, which we prefer, it is a question about whether the course will have the rigor that's required. So clearly, I think somebody in the previous, I think is now left, was going to University of Texas in Austin to do dual enrollment classes. That probably would be very comparable with the kind of courses we would have here. But it may not be true in a community college. So those are things that need to be talked about specifically with particular institutions. But definitely dual enrollment is better than AP. Is that a fair statement, Kayla?
Oh. Honestly, we just want you to take the college courses. So if you take it dual enrollment, if you take it IB, if you take it AP, we love it. It really just depends on the student and it depends on the school and what's going to be offered at your school. But just take some college classes and you'll be better off. It'll definitely better prepare you for engineering. Thank you for that, Dean Gibson.
From experience from the pre-engineering side, a lot of students that come in transfer those hours, AP, IB courses. They struggle at the college level. Some of them have taken the calculus, but it is not the same as the college level. You have to take it at a college in order to understand how the functionality is going to be once you get into college. Only good thing about it is when you take the ALEKS placement assessment test, it's really not a test as a pass or fail. It's more so to place you in your math levels. That would only be a tool to help you with, like if you've taken algebra all the way up to calculus, that will help you with that test. But as far as taking the classes to prepare you for engineering, you're going to need the college level of Calculus 1, Calculus 2.
Good point.
I have another question in regards to, because all this is valuable information, especially with my son being a freshman in high school, just to prepare us for what's to come in the next few years. But in terms of advisors, when we're looking at dual enrollment courses and other courses to help propel him to be ready for college, would the advisors on campus be available if I had some questions or to say, hey, could you look at his schedule? Does this make sense, you know, to propel him for where he wants to go? Is that something that the advisors would be interested or available to further discuss?
Yes, some students will parents send us transcripts for us to look over at the classes that you've taken. And also again, to pull the FAMU-FSU College of Engineering major curriculum map so that you'll see which courses you need to take. Also, you can also look at the course descriptions for the classes at FAMU-FSU so that you'll know what skills will be learned within those classes. And that will help because a lot of times students transfer in physics, but it is at the college physics level and not physics one with analytics calculus base. So it'll be a good idea to look at the curriculum map, see which level math and science there is. Also look at the course description to make sure that it matches what courses that you need for the major. If you want to email us at this time while we're working remotely away from the office, mm-hmm. we cannot open the emails from away from campus. So if you would email it to Kayla McLaughlin, she can email it to us with her email address and we can better answer your questions.
Okay, that's very helpful. I mean, obviously it'd be a little bit, a little bit beyond today because he's just a freshman in high school, but I'm just thinking just preparing mm-hmm. as we move forward, if that would be, something of interest, because we want to make sure it's a fruitful experience and he's not just taking classes that he really could focus on something else. So very good to know at least there's some accessibility to at least reviewing it maybe in the future, but thank you so much.
Also, it would be a good idea to ask the high school where he's taking his courses to see what level in high school, whether it's 11th grade, 12th grade, he can start doing the dual enrollment at a college or university to take those courses, the math and science courses. Aside from the being at the high school level, he could take them at the universities.
Okay, great to know. Thank you so much. Mm-hmm.
Okay, if there are no more questions, perhaps we'll end the session, but please contact any of us directly. I think you've got Kayla's email and she can always pass it on if you didn't get others. And we're glad that you took the time to, and we hope you come here and join us. Okay, thank you.
Thank you all, have a great Saturday.
Bye.
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 Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye, Eric.
Bye, everyone.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Sastry.
Bye.